No, Mum, they like me for my jokes, not my opal cable.
Actually, reverse that.
Mum, I gotta go, I'm at work, so I'll speak to you later. Love you.
Oh, it's wonderful to be at work. And early.
Thank you.
Oh, that's freezing!
I love my work shower! Yay! This is the best place in the world!
Oh! Well, I found a rock on the ground. Ooh, that's a goodie.
This is really actually quite a nice piece. I remember it before I lost it. So it's from the Wyoming field in Lightning Ridge, and it's a Nobby opal. Some beautiful colour sitting there on the top, and it's got that white cap only just forming on the top, so it looks like it will be pretty easy to take off. But whether it's clean, and if it is clean, that colour, that blue and that red colour combination is so rare and so beautiful, it could be a $5,000 plus stone. You just don't know until we get into there and have a look. But I do like the way the colour bar is making its way almost all the way around this little white cap. So let's see what we can do. Give it a bit of water, get a better idea of those colours. Alrighty, let's see if we can get some nice colour underneath that white cap. This is all the good signs of a nice nobby in one piece. So let's get that wheel going. Turn the water on. And we'll do what we normally do. Just start going around the edges a little bit. See there already that it's not going to be a black opal. Wow, it may be a black, but maybe only just. So I'm taking it in there because the sand spot or the cap on the top is showing that it's hitting the bottom, so it doesn't really matter too much that I'm taking some more away. So what is a good sign actually is this black potch there could darken the stone inside. There's a small chance, but it could. There is a chance. It's like Dumb and Dumber. You mean there's a chance? Like a million to one? So there's a chance. Working my way in, I really need to get it all the way into pretty much into there where the colour sits, and then we'll take its top off. Just starting on that side underneath that white cap, very thin, but just starting. So we can afford to go in a little bit further, and you can see it there too, it's just starting there. See that amazing red colour sitting right on that bar of hotch. So the chances here are really, really getting good of cutting something amazing. So this hole here could mess me up, but I need to find out what's going on underneath there. So it's time, I'm going in. Oh wow, that sand spot actually looks deeper than I thought it would be. Oh my lordy lord. Oh my. That's really opened up into a big sand blob right there. Eek. Major, major spanner in the works. I've lost all the colour on this side where the sand is, and that sand looks like it goes right in. So I may be only getting a stone out of here, which is a real shame. Could have been an amazing gem. So let's go further in and find out. Yeah, you can see that sand touching the bottom. No colour bar. No. Well, what could have been a 4-carat, 3 to 4-carat gem is now being squeezed down to possibly just 1 carat, so it's a bit of a shame. But that sand is my best friend and my worst enemy. See, as I go further in, it's still going, still making it quite hard. If I try and roll that sand out, you can see it coming out a little bit, but it's not going to come out all the way. This actually was a keystone in a very expensive parcel. And I had a lot of money riding on this one. So that's really pretty color, but geez, it's getting small. There is a good sign though, that you can see the color underneath the sand spot, so that should roll out and come clean. Yep. Trying to get all that potch off the back. So I'm still getting a gem. Nice colour. It's not 4 carats, but it's going to be around the 1.5 to 2, I would say. Very pretty colour. Just goes to show you can't tell from a plain knobby to the finished product. It can be vastly different to what you're expecting. and it really, you really need to take that into account when you're evaluating a piece of rough opal. Because there is always an element of risk. Sometimes life throws us curveballs. Sometimes we get wins, sometimes we get losses. You know, it's just like life, this opal cutting, and you've got to make the most of it. If you keep a positive frame of mind, you'll learn something from a bad situation. It's really important to keep a positive mindset. All right. Well, that was quite a ride. That really big sand blob in the center of the stone took a lot away from the stone, but still, it could have actually eaten most of the stone. So I'm still very lucky to have got a decent, beautiful little gem. And you know what? It sits on the edge of black opal, so I'm really quite happy. Also, weighs 1.72 carats. So we're looking at around about a $2,500 to $3,000 gem, which is really good. I'm actually stoked because it could have been nothing. So what a beautiful gem. Now I'd love to hear in the comments from you guys what pattern you think this is. So let me know. And every time somebody gets the pattern right, I will love your comment. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.